down here. They haven't opened yet.
I'm going to go to the next one. Young fellas, who have we got here? We've got a couple of like lads. Dave Starr. Dave Starr.
David. Likely lads, I don't know what we're likely about.
And when did you start? What's your connection to aviation here?
You name it.
What have you done?
What have I done?
Yeah.
Probably absolutely nothing.
Absolutely nothing. You fly, you're a pilot?
Yep. Yeah, no, yep. I started motor driving in the early 60s.
Early 60s, who
yep.
for?
James Aviation.
Whereabouts was that started?
Well, I was on the DC-3, so that was around from anything from Kaitaia to Taupo.
Kaitaia to Taupo?
Well, more or less, near enough.
Yeah.
And then the late 60s, went flying and went to Warkworth, and I'm still there.
Still loaded driving?
No, flying. I started flying in
69. Oh, you're
69.
Flying now?
Yeah.
69, you're starting. What are you flying now, then?
Flying Fletcher.
Still flying Fletcher?
Fletcher, yep.
Same company?
No, flying for myself, which I've been for the last 15, 16 years.
Oh, good stuff. Yeah. Yeah, and whereabouts for that again, or in the North Island?
Yeah, in Warkworth.
Warkworth,
just
okay.
north of Auckland.
Okay, and who's this young fellow over here you've been talking to?
This is Alan Rose.
Alan?
Yeah.
How are you, Alan? Yeah. And what's your connection in the aviation industry?
A loader driver.
And how long have you been loading driving for?
1952.
You started in 52?
52, yeah.
And who was that for?
Airspeed.
Aspect. And whereabouts did you start?
In Tauranga.
Whereabouts?
Tauranga.
Tauranga. And whereabouts have you been anywhere? Anywhere else?
Oh, Dannevirke for 2.5 years. Of the same firm, Airspeed.
And you're still flying, still loaded driving?
Yeah.
Yeah, you're still loaded driving?
Yeah.
Oh, you've got a bit of bull here.
No, there's no bull.
There's no bull, still loaded driving.
Yeah.
Same company?
No. Here are four firms through the years.
Four, that's not bad. Four jobs for the yeah. Oh, that's good. And you're going to enjoy the weekend?
Oh, yeah.
See a few of the old fellas and tell a few lies?
All lies. The lies, big beer, coming up now.
Yeah, after a few of those, it'll be even better still. All right, well, I hope you enjoy the evening and the weekend, and we'll catch later on.
I do the best anyway, just up of things anyway.
Good stuff. All right, catch later, guys. See ya.
Okay.
We've got John Brandon, is that right?
That's right, yes.
And what's your connection in aviation?
Later driving and operation manager, branch manager, two things.
And when did you start?
54.
1954, whereabouts?
Marston, air contracts in Marston.
Air contracts?
Yep.
And where'd you go from there? Still one
company? Well, the Manuturi or top dressing company, I went over there as driver for Naylor Smith.
Right.
And I went back to air contracts, and then 1970, I was operation manager in Wairarapa for Basil, Manuturi.
That's good stuff. I see your cohorts have disappeared. They're too scared of the old interview. All right, so what are you up to now? Enjoying the weekend so far?
Yes, I am, very much.
Yeah,
thank you.
Yeah.
You're seeing a lot of old faces.
Yeah, telling a few lies and that sort of stuff. And spinning a bit of super. Oh, it's good. Oh, well, I hope you enjoy the evening and the weekend.
Thank
and,
you, yes.
And you get a bit of kick out of the old boys flying tomorrow with a bit of
absolutely,
luck.
Yes, we will.
Okay, yeah, good one, John.
Thanks very much.
Later.
Yeah,
thanks.
Okay, bye.
That's right. Who have we got here?
This is the... Probably the first, he was the earliest guy to start top dressing in Hawke's Bay.
Okay.
That's Derek Turnbull.
Derek Turnbull.
Yes.
Okay, Derek, and when did you start top dressing?
Well, this was in 1950.
You started in 1950?
1950 with Tiger Moth.
Tiger Moth.
It might have even been late 1949.
Okay, and who was that for? What company?
That was myself.
That's right. Okay, and whereabouts?
It was in Hastings, Hawke's Bay.
Hawke's Bay, okay, yeah.
And we called it Hawke's Bay Wings Fertilizers. Wings Fertilizers.
Oh, that makes sense, yeah. That's good, yeah. How long were you doing that for?
I had it from 1949 right through to 1963. I then retired from there and bought a farm.
Okay, that's good. And after Tiger Moth, did you stay in the other aircraft at all?
Yes, we had Tiger Moth, Cessna airplanes, two Cessna airplanes, a Fletcher FE-24, and then four Pipers,
Warnies.
So you've more or less done the whole gamut, really, haven't you?
18 days. 18 days,
yeah.
That's right. And then I sold the whole works to Field Air in 1962, 61.
And all good straight flying? No hidden side of the hills, all that sort of stuff, or
what? Well, we got away scot-free.
Not
too much. Never had a fatality.
Yeah, that's good, eh? Oh, we're still here to enjoy the weekend and tomorrow's air show with a bit of luck, and
it should be good too.
Yeah, it should be good too.
I'm looking forward to it.
Oh, Derek,
see if they can do it the same as we used to do it.
Yeah. Oh, I don't think so. They're a bit more cautious now. Too many bureaucrats. All right, Derek, well, I hope you enjoy the weekend and we'll catch up to you again.
Good luck.
All right, now who we got here? Sorry to interrupt you guys. We got Peter, we got who we got here? We got Ken and we got Mike.
Yep.
And start with Mike. What's your connection to aviation?
None whatsoever.
If any.
The super phosphate's so thick that I'm having to wriggle out of it. So we're in the business.
You're in the business? Yep. Pilot or?
Was previously and now do a bit of managing.
Okay. Yeah. When did you start flying?
1969. Yeah.
Whereabouts?
In Raglan.
In Raglan?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
And what sort of aircraft are you flying then?
A 300 horsepower Fletcher.
Yeah. Okay. Stay with Fletcher all the time, or did you go into other aircraft?
Oh, moved on to 400 horsepower.
400, yeah.
Really and truly adventurous.
Oh, yeah, especially after, yeah.
Then got into a little bit more, then it was into a turbine, yeah.
Yeah, that's good, yeah. Okay, yeah. You're still flying, still in the business?
No.
You're not?
Gave that up, far too dangerous, mate.
Far too dangerous. Then we got here, we got Peter. And what's your connection, Peter, in the old aviation?
We build agricultural aeroplanes.
You build the planes. Okay, and these guys try and reckon for you.
Successfully too. Yes.
Yeah. And who do you work for? Or you're still working for them?
I own the company, that's Gippsland Aeronautics in Australia. In Australia.
It's Australia? Yeah. Okay, oh, it's good. So you come over here to hear what's going on?
Look at the wreckage, yes.
Look at the wreckage. Take some back or bring some new bits over with you?
No, we'll send them some bits, yeah.
That's good stuff, yeah. Now, what have you got there, Ken?
Yeah, no.
What's your connection to the aviation?
Well, I'm a top dressing pilot, yeah.
Yeah, and when did you start?
1973.
1973, whereabouts?
Yeah. Hastings.
Hastings.
Yeah.
You're still going?
Still there, still going.
And who's the company?
Me.
You. What, in Fletchers?
Yeah, a couple of Fletchers.
Okay, that's good, yeah. And going to be enjoying the weekend this weekend?
Oh, great. Yeah,
Should be right, good
to have a weekend off.
Excellent. Yeah. Oh, I hope you guys enjoy the weekend and we can see you around again.
Yep.
All right,
cheers.
Thank you. Excuse me, guys. Just got a little bit of interview here for the old aviation. Who we got here? We got Frank, Rex, and Ben. Is that right? Ben. Yeah. We'll start with you, Frank. What's your connection to aviation?
Well, I was instructing at Whanganui in 1947 when Rex and I sat together in the school, and we taught him later after I went through. He has ruined the industry ever since.
And do you have to do any flying yourself? You have to top dressing instructing?
Not here, but no, all around the rest of the world. Yeah.
Rest of the world, and for example, what?
Oh, it's Nigeria and Cameroons. I was in Panama for 4 years, okay. And then I was in the Sudan, and then I was in Jamaica.
Yeah. I heard a lot of guys going over to the desert type states. So what do you spray in those sort of countries, like Sudan and that sort of stuff?
Bananas. I was on most
bananas.
Of my time, yeah.
Okay, what, for disease, bananas?
They have to be sprayed every 2 weeks.
Wonderful.
Oh, okay,
wonderful job. Mm. So what happened now? You're still in the industry, or you're...
No, I finished.
Finished, yeah, okay.
It's a nice compliment you paid, never mind. I'm 73.
73, oh, that's good stuff. Okay, we go with the Rex here.
Frank Breed's Qantas pilot. His son is a Qantas pilot, yeah.
Oh, that's good stuff.
It's pretty satisfying for instructors if they can turn their children to it.
That's good stuff. Why, you, Rex, are you in the aviation yourself?
Absolutely, yeah, whole life of it. Starting off with engineering.
Yes.
In the very early days of aircraft service in Auckland,
right.
The first aeroplane that they converted was ANN. And I was working on that aeroplane.
And what sort of aircraft was that?
That's a Tiger Moth. One of the first Tiger Moths, yes.
Right, okay. And did you go into flying yourself, or was it straight?
Didn't stop at that. When Frank and I were together, we were on the school in Whanganui.
Right.
We were learning the game, and then we finished up teaching it.
Oh, it's great stuff, huh?
And subsequently, I went to Safe Air and had a major career in Blenheim.
Oh, that's good stuff.
Where I still live.
Yeah, it's good. We're going to Ben. He's trying to keep his beer warm under his armpit there.
He's our wild Australian boy.
What's your connection to aviation, Ben?
Oh, I've been an Aggie pilot, you know, all this time.
Okay. Yeah. And when did you start?
I finished last top dressing run just last Friday.
You finished?
Not finished, no. Oh, I hope not, but hope not. Just before I came here, I got a job finished.
And when did you start flying?
In 1958. These were my instructors, these fellas.
These guys here?
At Whanganui, yeah.
Oh, you're still here, so they must be pretty good instructors, don't they?
Well, thank you.
And what's the aircraft are you flying?
Oh, most of the Aggie stuff, you know, the top dressing planes and a bit of GA stuff.
In New Zealand only, or overseas?
No. I did a little bit here earlier on, with these fellas, and I worked in Taranaki for a while.
Right, okay, yeah.
Yeah, and then I went back to Aussie, and I've worked in the Sudan and the UK.
Okay,
and
what's it like working in these sort of hot countries? Good?
Oh, depends what's hot's over there.
Yeah. I'm talking about the weather.
Not all that hot. In the southeastern part of Australia where I've worked mostly, it's quite cool there, on those tablelands.
Yeah, and what is spraying in Australia? It's
top dressing,
bananas,
mostly that.
Bananas again?
No. The bananas are way up north in Australia. No, I'm in the southern part.
Right.
You know, in eastern Victoria, the eastern highlands.
Oh, it's good. Oh, Ben, I hope you enjoy the weekend and, get on with your mates here and we'll see you again.
Thank you.
Okay, all right, good one.
Good on you. Thanks.
There we go. Then we've got a couple of like lads. We've got Jim and John. Jim and John. Now, what did you do, Jim? What were you doing? Flying?
Yes, I was flying for... I started off in the hangar, did a bit of load of driving, and then went flying, and then operations manager after that.
Well, that's good. And this guy over here, what was he doing for you?
John was load of driving for me.
Okay. And, John, when did you start load of driving?
In Marston, 1954.
Yeah.
Tiger Moth.
Yeah. And you're loading for Jim, were you?
I loaded for Jim in 1960, about 1961, 60-61. Yeah, about 1960-1961.
Now, you're starting a little story before about the beach. What's the background on that beach bit you're talking about?
Well, we were working on a strip out by the coast, just west of Marston, and it was a hot sunny day, and we ran out of super, and we were waiting for some trucks to arrive. And I spotted this little beach down below there. It looked very inviting. So I said to John, let's go down for a swim. He said, oh, no thanks. No, I'll just wait here, I think. And I said, well, I'm going. I'm as hot as hell. So I went down and there was a bit of a sea breeze coming in. I landed into wind on the strip, on the beach at least. And I went to turn away from the water and turned downwind to park it, and I ran into some soft sand, and just at that moment the wind gusted up very strong, and as the aircraft struck the soft sand, of course the tail came up and this wind got under the tail, and I had it teetering on the top with full throttle and the stick ride back trying to pull the tail down, but no luck. Finally I gave up and I just cut the throttle and she went over onto nose into the sand. Now John spotted me from up on the strip. He saw what had happened, so he brought the loader down to pull me out. And you wouldn't believe it, he got the loader stuck in the sand too.
Bit embarrassing, eh?
Meantime, the tide's coming in. Luckily for us, there were some fishermen had seen what had happened. They were just along the beach and they had a four-wheel drive, a big Land Rover. They came along and pulled us both out. I had a bent prop on the aircraft, but it was not too bad. And
was that the Tiger?
It was Cessna 180.
Yeah. And you couldn't fly home then, could you?
Oh, yeah, I could. Yeah, it wasn't bent badly, but it was bent enough to annoy the boss, Colin James, and warranted having to be flown back up and new prop put on. But
and did you get your swim in the end?
No, that's the thing. I never did get a swim.
I'd actually gone to have a bit of a sleep.
Okay.
And I was sort of lying there with my eyes shut, and I actually saw him land on the beach. I lay back and I heard the thing rev up to, you know, as he went to swing it round, and it sort of hello. I looked over the beach and he was on his nose.
Oh, it's good stuff, and it's one of those little stories that you remember from way back, eh? So it's those are the good stories to hear off too, eh? You know,
they come out right. That's the main thing.
Yeah, those are coming out. Yes, excellent. All right, guys, I hope you enjoyed the rest of the evening and tomorrow and the weekend, and we'll catch up with you again.
Thank you.
Okay, John. Okay, Jim. Yes, later. We've got Lex here. We've got Lex, Tom, and we've got Ken. We want to do a few words off you on the old flying type careers and that. When did you start, Lex?
Where did I start? In Gore, 1977.
In Gore?
Yes.
Okay, what did you start flying with? What's your aircraft?
UH-12E, Hiller 12E.
Oh, the old Hiller. So yes. you're a rotor wing pilot?
Yes, I am.
Still are. Yes. And what are you flying now?
500.
500? Yeah, okay. It's good. And still in Gore, or?
I live in Gore, but I work offshore a lot of the time.
Okay, and where are you working from then?
I work for a Canadian company.
Okay, so in Canada, obviously.
A lot of the time.
Okay, what sort of work do you do over there? Sort of
mining, ag work. Forest work.
Yeah, you mentioned Mexico as well. Same sort of work there as well?
Seismic work.
Okay, seismic work. Okay, so dropping bombs and seeing where the old seismic waves come to.
That's right.
Good stuff. Yeah, did you start flying in New Zealand?
Yes, I did.
In Gore?
Yes, I did.
Okay, and straight to rotor wing, or were you doing fixed wing first?
I couldn't find a job fixed wing.
Right.
I had a fresh commercial.
Right.
So I got my rotary wing license.
Oh, that's good.
And I got a flying job rotary wing first.
Oh, excellent.
So I've
excellent.
Continued on.
Oh, excellent. Where's that mountain man gone? Oh, we'll go over to Ken here. Go and see Ken. Where did you start flying, Ken?
In Gore.
In Gore as well.
1974, yeah.
Fixed wing again, or rotor wing?
Fixed wing, Tiana.
Fixed wing, yeah. Okay, yeah.
And, I actually started in Tiana.
Tiana?
Yeah.
Oh, okay, what's the aircraft you start flying in?
A 188.
188 Cessna.
Yeah.
Oh, ag wagon. Yeah. Okay, yeah. And all over the country, or?
No, just can't get away from the place.
Can't get away from the place.
I'm still in Gore, yeah.
Good place, eh? Yeah. Okay. And who are you working for down there?
Myself, Mackenzie Aviation.
Mackenzie Aviation. Yeah. Okay, got a lot of work on? Plenty on?
Oh, no, we're always...
Downturn of the normal...
That's right, yeah. You got it, yeah.
Okay. Oh, it's good. Well, I hope you're enjoying the weekend here so far.
Yeah. And, I won't be here for the next 50. Will you be here for the next 50?
Oh, I don't think so, no. No, but this stuff could be in the old archives anyway.
Yeah.
Well, I hope you're enjoying the rest of the weekend, and we'll chat to you again.
Yeah, right,
okay, sure. Good one.
On okay. Right.
Okay, here we go. We're swapping telephone numbers here, are we? Where's he gone? You get back here.
He's taken off.
Now, who we got here? We got Joan. We've got Joan, Peter, and Monica. We'll start with you, Joan. What's your connection in aviation?
Well, it's through my friend Frank Sinnott. Through my friend Frank Sinnott, who was in Whanganui many years ago.
Right.
Involved with the aerial top dressing.
Right, okay.
Yes.
Yep,
and we're both Australians.
Oh, okay. So you come over from Australia, have you? Or?
No, I've been here since 1957.
1956, so you're a true blue Kiwi then, I guess.
Yes, yes. Right, thank you. Would you make here? I'm passing on to my friend.
We're going to Peter. Peter here, Peter and Monica. When did you start flying, Peter? What's your connection in aviation?
I learned to fly in the mid-50s, and I top dressed from about 57 through to 1960.
1960.
Yeah, and then went to NAC, National Airways.
Okay.
Then to Air New Zealand.
Air New Zealand.
Yeah.
Okay, what are you doing now? Flying 747s?
No, I'm retired and loving it. Yeah.
Is that a good feeling, right?
Yeah. Well, flying big jets beat the hell out of working for a living.
Yeah, right.
Top
So what did you start flying in?
Tiger Moths.
Yeah. Okay.
Learned to fly in Tiger Moths.
Okay, and before that, though, did you always have an interest in flying?
As a youngster, whatever? Yes, my father was an electrical engineer.
Right.
And did all the electrical wiring for all the fighter airfields around Auckland, Ardmore, Seagrove, Mangere during the war.
Right.
And I got the bug.
You got the bug, eh? And you couldn't lose it.
No.
Oh, that's excellent. Yeah. And what's your lovely wife, Monica, is it?
Yes.
Okay, what's it like being the wife of a pilot?
Very enjoyable. I now fly behind him in a little chipmunk.
Oh, that's that right.
Yes,
yeah,
so okay. I follow him.
Oh, okay, so you've got a license behind. As well?
No, I just hang on behind.
Just hang on tight.
Yes. Okay. Thoroughly enjoy the scenery and everything.
Oh, it's excellent. Well, I've been enjoying the weekend so far, and I get your show tomorrow, and we'll see you again.
Yes.
All right, thank you very much. Where are you?
Thank you.
Good luck. Got a couple of local lads here. Who we got here? We got one here called Bill.
And Neil.
And Ross.
And Diane.
Okay, we'll start with you, Bill. What's your connection to the old aviation?
I did my engineering apprenticeship with Airland, which is now Field Air.
Field Air, okay. So just engineering or just
engineering flying? And load of driving. Yeah.
Okay. And how many tons of super director you would have loaded over the years?
Hell.
A few.
We'll have a clue now.
Oh, okay.
Goes back a few years ago.
Are you still doing it now or you?
No, I'm flying for Eagle Air now.
Eagle Air, okay.
Got out of the industry.
Okay, yeah, good. And when did you start actually doing flying?
Hey Neil, we learnt together, didn't we?
Can't be that long ago, can it?
75? About 75. Yeah, it would have been about 75.
75,
yeah.
What did you start flying in?
A little Bulco 208 at the Palmerston Flying School.
Oh, okay, yeah,
with,
right,
Brian,
okay.
Brian
yeah.
Milne.
Okay, right, okay. And how long are you doing that for?
I ended up going up to New Guinea from here and flying up there. So quite a few years up there. And
yeah.
Came back to Field Air again.
Yeah, right, okay.
And
yeah.
Load of driving engineering. Yes. Bit of time with Peter Lacey, down in Nelson.
Yeah.
Then went back overseas again for 7-odd years in New Guinea, back to Australia and back to here.
What's the attraction for New Guinea? Money?
No, the flying.
The what?
Yeah, the flying.
The challenge.
Yeah.
Why? What's the challenge in New Guinea?
Just really good flying.
Okay. Yeah.
It's like top dressing, except it's in the passenger freight industry.
Okay, right. Yeah.
Every day was a challenge. The flying was excellent.
Yeah.
And I really miss the place.
Oh, it's good stuff. Yeah. I suppose it's, like I say, the challenge with the mountains and that is what we're talking about, the terrain, the type of country you're flying in.
You can throw the map out.
Yeah.
It's like, I consider it to the ag industry in the respect that, you just got to know the terrain, know the area, and local knowledge, and talk to the people who have been there a lot longer. To me, that's what it is, and I'd go back there tomorrow if I could. It's just unfortunate the way that went, but I got talked out of going ag flying, believe it or not. You can blame Barry Tibbs for that, because I wanted to go ag flying. I did a stint with managerial top dressing.
Right.
And I had a plane lined up for me and everything like that. And Barry said, I don't want you to go ag flying.
Yeah.
He said, it's a different game and what have you. He said, you're a good engineer. He said, go and do something else. So I ended up back in New Guinea. But I've never ever forgotten the ag industry. I just really loved it.
Excellent.
And in some ways, I'm glad that I didn't go that way.
Right.
Lost a lot of friends and the way the industry's gone.
Yeah.
But at the same time, I've just arrived back from Cairns tonight in Australia.
Yeah,
came straight from Cairns to here today to be here for the 50th.
Bloody hell, it's good on you. So, all right, well, our battery's going flat, so we might get back to you later on. Okay, well, hope you enjoy the weekend and we'll catch up to you.
Thanks very much.
Thanks a lot.
Thank you.
I've given you, that's the original roster, but it's been a few deletions there, sure that people can't get in because of weather problems. So that's the amended timetable there, and where we're going to go. Here's my list. On the back page, it's that same map again, displaying the flight line. The most important part is the flight line, which is a mono green strip, 3 metre wide strip, 10 metre wide strip down the runway here, side runway. It's cut over the taxiway here, 100 metres out. It's quite obvious, so if that's your flight line, display line. So all your flights to be either there or that way, not this way. Those aircraft that we were top dressing will be getting loaded up this corner here. We've got a helps later come to lay a bit of line for each aircraft. And your top mission of those that will be spraying will be picking up water from just outside the hangar here, the water source here, the water into here, the money fox is getting loaded now. Again, thanks for lining up the way you did, that's great. That's good. One or two caution things we've got at the moment, we've got this end of the airfield, we've got horses, and we've got a built up area, and the same with the other end of the airfield here, up here, and horses as well. So please, all your turns away from that area there, out there, free space out here, and also the pre-down area out here. So make sure all your turns away from this area here, and right over there as well. We've got 119 as a radio frequency, but if we stick to our schedule there, I haven't actually got a base radio, you've got a base radio to work to, but that is the intended flight schedule. If there's any problems, I'll come and see you before you go up. If I need to hurry you up or slow you down. Again, well, there's a few little pointers here. First thing, safety is a priority of this operation. And no big bloody heroics like we had last time. That scared the shit out of me. So please keep it safe, keep it professional. There's got a lot of public people here today, public looking at the show as well. Let's put on a good show for them. It's professional, let's show them we are professionals and what we do. Please keep care of all the built up areas. And all flying will be done on the sway line or beyond it. All turning, no turning out this area, please. But anything goes wrong, we've got a cool line here, down here as well. So please, turn from that mast strip that way. Again, the radio frequency 1191. If there's any problems, I'll contact you. Or if you have any problems, you can contact me at 1191. I'll be listening out for you. And again, when you finish the display, just come back to life. We are there now. Well, be great, thank you. And then, keep it safe, enjoy it. Please know, don't want any accidents. So keep it safe within your capabilities and the airplane's capabilities. Yeah, we'll start, as I said, with Tigers. Tiger first, we might have an interlude. We've got further up, we've brought George further up with TV3's here today, but they'll do us good on George, so. So you're on?
Yeah.
You'll be on at 14:50, I think it was, George. 14:50. 14:50, yeah.
14:35, you're on.
And hopefully the rain will stay away for us for this 2 hour period. Any questions? Across the rip roll on here is not filling airdrome airspace, so please keep, if you are going out there and turning around, please don't go that way. You'll bounce off in a half the airspace. The upper limit here is 1500 feet, so please, any big wingovers, people over 1500 feet, if you're doing that. Keep it safe, keep it within your limits. Any questions?
Turn the wind around.
You got initially blown.
There you go.
Oh, sure, I have to. There you go.
Do we just taxi out at our discretion, do we?
Yes, if you just taxi out, we are parking, just taxi out to, you can either use the either runway for takeoff or out just on the grass vector here. You'll see this is quite a fine line here. Just taxi out from there, just taxi out there to. And just come back in again with grass and just park where you were, or else the next vacant spot.
In our case, can we go out in Haliton?
Yes. We can taxi out while one's performing, the other one's sort of line up ready to go. So this is probably a continual sequence.
What about loading up?
Yeah. If we get the right guys, if we're going to cart fertiliser, get up this loading unit now, days we're going to spray coming over this area here. The pillars going to come across here, the line of pipe just been done. Where is the spray? Yeah, the hell's going to come spraying, but he'll fill up later on. The aircraft that'll be top using, I'm looking at. An ag wagon and a Fletcher, it'll be Steve and a Fletcher.
The 105 will be spraying,
Steve and Fletcher will be top using, the GA200 will be top using, Rob will be our Fletcher. Bruce, is that okay? You do three supplies for some life for it? And then the air tractor, John? Yeah. Is that okay?
Yep.
Yeah. He had a strap over here, surely, so...
It's just gone past the line.
Has it? Right, good.
Just been past the line.
And there will be an ag wagon, probably CSM, but well, if I can get hold of Ben Redwine's machine, I'll be his, otherwise it'll be CSM, top wrestling. There'll be one, two, three, five top wrestling, two sprayers. Or three sprayers. So, that's the order of sequence of the aircraft. Those who are just doing flight paths, just throw it right up the airfield and run back down again and land. Just nothing spectacular, it's just showing the aircraft off to the people. That's all that is. The top missing guys will do the same again.
You do the whole length of the field.
Yeah, just run, because your turning area is over here and over here, so you just run down there. They turn, and those who want to do a handling display after that couple of runs, they can just do a few steep turns or turn. Handling, slow flight, fast flight, whatever they like to do. Was on that display line further north. Yeah, so each one, you've got 5 minutes each, you guys, and the formation's got a little bit longer, about 7 or 8 minutes for every team.
We can land anywhere we like, Bob, outside the main strip. We don't have to use the runway.
No, we have to use the runway. Runway's optional for you guys, yeah. Just if the grass is dry enough to land on. Yeah, we land on the main strip here, or else you're not anywhere on the grass, but again, if you can, so use that main strip as your landing spot.
You can land on that main strip.
Yeah, it's just tall hard. The whole airfield's usable, there's no wet spots on it at the moment. It's all the rain we just had.
How long has it gone in the truck with you manned all day? So the latent shows how you're standing up.
True. I'll go and see him. So once you're ready to clean up, Bruce will just send you over for him. I'll go and see
him,
he'll talk to
him
as well.
You're going to be doing well to keep the time, aren't you?
Well, it's up to you, fellas, it's time.
Not up to us.
That is a pretty
quick one. 5 minutes is not long, is it?
No, the radio's fine. I'll either sit in the aircraft or outside of your office. You've got to pay for it.
That's been a particular
life. Okay, I'll sit on the aircraft. Those who want it, again, some of the aircraft are in auto.
You're in auto.
Take some of your parking space to clear and just line up and wait till you wait till the other first guy's landed, then take off.
So you're not hanging around out there?
Well, it's either have a whole heap of airplanes out there
floating
around or else having each one land. Because you're going to be fairly close to circuit anyway, so the time you do your up and down the runway there a couple of times, do a couple of steep turns and so forth, and land, well, it's not going to take real long. You've got 5 minutes to do what you want to do on it, so keep it safe. Oh, jeez. You want me to watch? So, you've all got one of these, so please, that's the routine. So, you follow that. Jeff and I come along, Captain Lloyd, I'm sorry, on the shoulder, so it's short turn now. Any other questions?
Oh, so, we, as one lands, we and the next one takes off?
Yeah.
Is that how you want to work it?
Well, what's the best way to do it?
I don't know.
One lands this side and the other one takes off that side. So that aircraft's clear.
Triple sequence on the south.
Come back in, just come back here. Parking area.
You wouldn't want to park here and somebody's down to the side.
No.
he's so crossed the blue line off line. On the other side of that split. Yeah. So yeah. You're right of the way anyway.
Yeah. Okay, if we have one landing, one taking off, keep the separation. I'm taking off one player, step over the airfield then. The one landing lands on this side of the flight line. It's really obvious out there. You can say we're going to keep this on the terminals.
Can I just go
across
the
line?
Up to that line?
Up to that line, yeah.
The 10 will spread the way out?
Yeah. Just make sure we don't come any further forward than that.
That
colour doesn't look impressive coming along. Yeah, so if you just start up where you're parking this, as you're swooping the list there, who's going to be next, just start up and follow out, set line up there, wait to turn, and then once that one, unless you go past it, if he's finished up to the takeoff area there, then this one, I'll just add a separation for both of you.
We'll have to load those, so we'll have to taxi back to get a load there.
Yeah. Well, those won't get line, I'll probably bring you back.
It's getting too long.
It's been
a
minute.
Yeah.
Yeah,
we'll wait. There's a big loading bay over here.
Yeah.
Well,
Well, there's a place.
Makes it go long.
Well, sorry.
That's funny, isn't it?